even as COVID-19 vaccination distribution is set to hit record levels in the U.S., many eligible Texans are still struggling to get their shots and wondering about fairness. Dallas County's judge says it's because the state is shortchanging the Dallas-Fort Worth area on doses. Our Carolyn Vandergrift talked to some who say they traveled hours just to find their dose.
As the vaccine wait lists in Dallas and Tarrant County continue to grow,
I think we were just getting anxious because a lot of our friends had, you know, already gotten the first shot and we weren't getting any calls.
North Texans tired of waiting are taking vaccine road trips instead.
It's about a 2-hour drive.
About 2 hours and 40 minutes.
An hour and 45 minutes, and I got my vaccine.
Many people have found available appointments in more rural parts of the state and say it's worth the trip.
You know, I have a son, and obviously he can't get the vaccine now, but you know, if my husband and I are vaccinated, that's a way of protecting him.
I'm happy I did it. It's a great investment of time to protect others from COVID.
But Dallas County Judge Clay Jenkins says North Texans shouldn't have to drive hours to get vaccinated.
There's really no reason at all for that, you know, other than politics, which really shouldn't play a role in public health.
Judge Jenkins says the state stopped sending Dallas and Tarrant County's fair share of doses a few weeks ago when federal vaccination clinics opened up in Dallas and Arlington.
That's no way to beat COVID. The way to beat COVID is to do it population adjusted across the state.
The state says it does try to keep vaccine allocation roughly proportional to county population to be as fair as possible. But for those who had to drive far for their shot, it doesn't feel that way.
There are so many people like myself who are traveling to rural Texas to get the vaccine.
The Department of State Health Services says about 7 in 10 people have gotten the vaccine in the county where they live. But there are people traveling from urban to rural areas and vice versa. Caroline Vandergriff, CBS 11 News.